Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate how you can implement pause functionality in ScreenFlow in Salesforce Lightning. Before starting, if you want to follow Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube and you can follow my YouTube channel. Here you will find various playlists related to Salesforce and other programming languages. So now coming on to the topic. If you have implemented any screen flow, so on each screen you will see in the footer part pause button is available, and from control navigation we can decide whether we want to show pause button or not, and also we can mention pause confirmation message. So let me first click on debug. So whenever we click on debug, so we can test our flow that is implemented without placing it on record page or any action button. So if I run this, so here you can see pause button is not available, right? So to enable this button, you need to search for process automation setting. And under this page, you will find an option that is let users pause flow. So you need to enable this checkbox and click on save. So now this setting is enabled, and this time if I click on debug, so pause button will be there. And before showing you that button, I am just mentioning pause confirmation message. So I'm typing this flow is paused, search paused flow interviews in setup to resume the flow, right? So I think now you also got to know how we can resume our paused flows. So I am saving this change, clicking on debug. So this time you will see on the screen pause button is available. Yeah, here it is. And if I click on this button, you will see it is asking for a reason. So I'm just typing test, clicking on OK. And on right hand side, you can see the interview was paused, date and time are available. Reason is also shown. And the confirmation message is this flow is paused. Search paused flow interviews in setup to resume the flow. So why this confirmation message is important? Because you can show your users like how they can resume the flows. Those are paused. So here I can search paused flow interviews. If I click here, so you will see a record is available here. If I open this record, it will show all the related information. So this is record number, paused reason is available here, paused date and time, interview level, like which interview or which flow you paused, that label is available. Then current flow information, this is the API name, version, then the current element, which screen caused this pause to be flow, sorry, this flow to be paused. And the flow information, this is the flow API, flow type is screen flow, and then system information, right? Now, here you have two buttons, delete or resume. And if we go back, so here also you have two buttons, delete and resume. So if you click on resume, so it will be resumed from that moment where you paused the flow. So let's say you have 10 screens and you paused your flow on fifth screen. So it will automatically resume from the fifth screen. And you can fill all the information and click on next. So this way, this functionality works. So let's say if I enter opportunity name, click on next. So on next screen, this pause button is available. But for screen two, we didn't enter pause message. So now if I click on this button, so it will ask for the reason, but it will not show the message like from where you can resume your flow. So this flow interview is now paused. This message is displayed, not custom message is displayed. So if I click on OK, so earlier record number was 5. If I click on refresh, so you will see record number will be 6 because we again paused this flow. on another screen. So one more record will be created. So here it is, right? And if I resume this flow, so you can see it is resumed from the second screen only. So this way you can pause or resume your flow with the help of screens, or you can say screen element that are available in the screen flow. So remember that we can pause only screen flow, because in case of auto launch flow, we don't have any screens. And if we don't have any screen, then we won't be able to show pause button or click on pause button. So remember that you can pause screen flows and you can resume that also. I shown you two settings, like from process automation setting, you can enable the checkbox so that pause button will be available. And by searching pause flow interviews, you will see all the records related to the flows. Those are paused so that you can resume. So I hope you understood pause functionality, how it works in ScreenFlow. If you want to follow more Salesforce training videos, you can search my name, Sanjay Gupta, on YouTube. And here you will find various playlists related to Salesforce and other programming languages. So thank you for watching this video.